Vibe coding, Cursor, that's what I got for you. So let's start with the demo of the quick application that I have created. There is a login page. This is the admin view. There is a dashboard. My task is a private view. Whatever task I create, if it is a private task, in that case, it's going to be visible here. I will be able to move it to in progress, but this will not be visible on the public board. This will allow me to track my own task without actually sharing it with the team. And then there are users. Being an admin, I can create users. And obviously for the regular user, this will not be there. Let's start with the basics. I had a vague idea and I wanted Cursor to create this tool for me. But what do we know so far after talking to ChatGPT that you need to give detailed prompt. Now, if you want to create a detailed prompt that can create applications, probably you are thinking about outsourcing or asking a junior developer. One way which I followed is using ChatGPT. So turned on ChatGPT's voice mode and ChatGPT, I want to create an application which is like a Kanban board, but has a public board and a private board. I want to use private board where users can actually keep track of the private task, which they don't want to disclose to admin. Can you help me create a PRD?
Sure thing. Let's outline the key points for the PRD.
ChatGPT can help me refine my vague ideas into something concrete. For example, what are the features of Jira? Does Jira have this feature? What are the features of Asana? Or what are the features of Trello? And I can think about all these competitive software and refine my approach. After this conversation, the final output that I want is a PRD. When you open Cursor for the first time, this is how it is going to look like, or probably something like this. Either way, you need to start with a new folder. Press Command Shift E and open a new folder. Once you open a folder, Cursor is going to look something like this, where you have multiple folders, multiple pans. This one, if it is not available, you can use this button or press Command I. Now there are three keyboard shortcuts, Command K, Command I, and Command L. These are very important shortcuts for Cursor, and we'll talk about these shortcuts. Command I is for talking to your AI. Now AI has two modes, agent and ask. Ask is just like ChatGPT where you ask questions, and these questions do not have to be around coding. You can ask about like, how do you make an espresso? And it will give you answer. Agent is where it will go and examine your code base and it will help you create files. You just have to click yes, 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 allow, 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 and it will create the entire file structure, and chat is going to give you only this code block. For example, you want to modify config.py. What do you want to modify? Explain this to chat and it will suggest you that this is the snippet. You will get an apply button and you will be able to apply. But the point is, agent can run by itself and in chat mode is good for asking, clarifying or making small adjustment. Now, before I go further, let's look at a few more settings of Cursor. Now, by the way, if it is looking similar to VS Code, you are not wrong. This is a fork of VS Code. The terminal, this right pan, the left pan, everything is similar to that. And you can see that there is Cursor settings and VS Code settings. You can customize VS Code settings, but I'm going to look at Cursor settings for now. The first thing is your account. You have to log into a user, right? Based on your login, you will see a lot of things here. The first one that I want to highlight is privacy mode. This privacy mode is very good when you are concerned about your source code leaking into the internet or being used for training. If you enable privacy mode, then your source code will not go to the cloud. This is one important thing to have. Now let's talk about features. In the features, the first thing that you see here is Cursor tab. Cursor tab is just like tab 2 autocomplete. Now it's on steroids because it is run by AI. Another good feature that I like here is auto import. Then we have chat, the highlight of Cursor. Now default new chat mode can be agent or ask, right? When I press Command I, does it open in agent or does it open an ask? That is what it determines. You can go through all the settings. I'm just going to highlight the important ones. Out of all these settings, perhaps the most important one is this auto run mode. Let's say if you want to create 50 files, it will give you commands to create those 50 files, but you have to click on run, 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 run. That can be very irritating if you are going to make a large number of changes, right? In such cases, if you enable this, then what will happen? This command is going to take care of running all the commands by default, except the ones which are in denial list. As you can see here that there are certain commands which are in denial list, including the delete file prevention. These are very good because you can specify that these commands should never be run automatically. Otherwise, everything will be run automatically. Then let's talk about code base indexing. This is important because whatever folder you open, it is going to create an index, and that index of that code base is actually sent with every chat, and that is what makes Cursor being aware about just not just one file, but all the files. But it also means that if you have larger number of files, it will take longer to index, number one. Number two, your context will be larger. Number three, which is the most important one, is if you have proprietary code, code will never be shared if you enable privacy mode, but this index will still go to the cloud. Something to keep in mind. Then in the models tab, you can enable and disable certain models. Some of the models, whatever models you disable, when you press command I, they will not be listed here. For example, in coding, what I've seen is 3.7 Sonnet or 3.5 Sonnet, whatever you have access to, those work well. If you enable thinking mode, that works even better. But the downside is that it will take longer because it is going to go into, you know, think. It's going to take time to think. For larger changes, thinking mode enabled is good. For smaller changes, you can just disable this thinking mode. Then we have rules. These are the rules that you can customize based on what you write and what are the problems that you see in using Cursor. A lot of rules here. For example, I saw that Cursor is not creating virtual environment all the time. So I've just created use virtual environment and set it to true. By the way, you don't have to write like this. You can just write in plain language or plain English. Always use virtual environment when working with Python. Something like that. That will also work. I've kept it shorter form because it is easier to manage. There are common mistakes to avoid. If I see that there are certain common things that it keeps doing again and again, then of course I've added those things as well. And some of the good things which I generated using ChatGPT. MCP server is where you can specify whatever MCP server you want Cursor to use. Now, if you don't know what is MCP server, if you want to know from me, then please leave a comment and I'll be happy to create a video about MCP server for you. Now, at the beginning of this video, we created a PRD using ChatGPT, right? This is the PRD. And if you look at it, you can see that this was a voice conversation. And towards the end of it, what I got? A PRD in Markdown format. Markdown format is good when you're talking to AI. Now here, I can just paste in this, open question, remove that. And most important thing, start with front-end only. Now, what it is going to do is it is going to look for all the changes. It's going to basically create the entire application. And if you remember, auto run is enabled. That's why I don't have to go and accept each line. Now, if you're thinking that there is going to be any magic and Cursor is going to build your entire application, it's not going to be like that. It is always going to face problems. Your cycle is going to be write code, write prompt, fix the problem, take the error code, paste it here, ask it to fix it, then something else is broken. And there will be a lot of things that you have to resolve. Now, this application which I showed you was very simple, but it took me an entire day to build it, right? I was not continuously working on it, but you have to come back to it, let it work and step away. It takes a lot of time. I have certain best practices which I've written for you. The first thing is you should always start with a PRD and like PRD in Markdown. I've already shown you when you write PRD, you have a lot of details which are good for technical requirements. Then secondly, you should always break down PRD in smaller section. The way I showed you in this video, I just pasted in the entire PRD. It is not going to be helpful. Instead of that, if you start with smaller chunks of information, right? Start with front end first, for example. Even in the front end, start with create, let's say, dashboard first, create users later, and create roles even later. Break down whatever your requirements is into smaller portion, and then it will take care of managing your application. So this plus button, command N, this is your new chat button, right? This new chat button is something that you should use a lot, especially after major steps. Otherwise, your context will become too big and it will start dropping the information that probably was important. Next thing, when you are ready to test the application, don't run it yourself. Ask Cursor to run it and monitor the output. This is going to help you a lot. If there is any error, Cursor will know immediately. Otherwise, you will have to copy paste. Even after there are errors, then in that case, press F12 in your browser. And whatever is there in the console, all the errors, if you paste in the screenshot, it is going to help Cursor resolve the errors. Other way to help Cursor is to provide some code samples, some approaches that, you know, perhaps you can do this. If things go wrong in Cursor, you can always go back to a checkpoint. Every chat that you start has a checkpoint. And if you click this button, it will revert everything to that checkpoint. But instead of that, it is better that you rely on Git. Use that, but use Git as well, time to time. Use Git add, Git commit, and always review every file that it generates. Which brings me to the final comment. Cursor is powerful and every developer should use it. There is no doubt about it. If you use VS Code, replace that with Cursor. With that note, I want to make it very clear that if you are not a developer, it is not possible to generate anything serious using Cursor. You need to have some understanding of programming, and only in that case you can use Cursor. If you want to take a deeper dive into Cursor, if you want me to create more videos on Cursor, do let me know in the comments. I'll see you in the next one.